Pineapple is a sweet and juicy fruit with a unique texture. Technically, a pineapple is characterized as a type of berry, which makes it similar to many other common berries like blueberry and cranberry, as well as some common berries like banana. But unlike these other berries, a pineapple is not a fruit. In fact, every time you look at a single pineapple, you should stop calling it a fruit. But do you know why that is? And do you know what you should be calling a pineapple? Well, we'll explain that in this video as we'll be discussing a brief overview of pineapple. And we'll also explain how eating pineapple may affect your health based on scientific evidence. So make sure you watch the video till the end. But first, have you subscribed to Nutritional yet? We help you make the right decision about what to eat and how to eat for good health by sharing scientifically accurate food tips and facts. Kindly subscribe now and turn on the notification bell so you will know whenever we upload a new video. And remember to drop us a like. Okay, let's get back. Pineapple, which is botanically known as Ananas commosus, is believed to have originated from Central and South America, where it has been cultivated for many centuries. Then, around the 17th century, it was said to have been introduced to Europe by Christopher Columbus. But today, many cultivars of pineapple are grown in many tropical regions around the world, including the Americas, Africa, India, Malaysia, and Australia. The cultivars differ from each other based on their size, shape, flavor, texture, and adaptability to different growing conditions. The most commonly grown cultivar worldwide is the smooth cayenne, which has smooth leaves and is well adapted to canning and processing. Some other cultivars include hilo, red spinach, and natal queen. Now, remember I said that a pineapple should not be called a fruit? Well, that's because every pineapple you see is made up of several berries that have developed from individual ovaries of several flowers. As each berries continue to grow, they all fuse together to become the fruit you know as pineapple. So when I said you should not call it a fruit, that's because it's not a single fruit. Instead, pineapples are referred to as multi-fruits or collective fruits. But a pineapple is not just a collection of several fruits. This wonderful fruit is also a collection of several important nutrients that offer a wide array of health benefits. One cup serving of fresh pineapple, which is about 165 grams, contains approximately 82 calories, 22 grams of carbohydrate, 2.3 grams of fiber, 78.9 milligrams of vitamin C, 0.2 milligrams of vitamin B6, 21.5 milligrams of calcium, and other minerals such as iron, magnesium, manganese, potassium, and many more. Although its protein content is low, it's equally low in fat and cholesterol, which makes it a good food for people with heart disease. This wonderful nutrient, together with others that we didn't mention, work together to confer amazing health benefits to those who eat pineapple, especially when you eat it regularly. So, here are 10 impressive health benefits of pineapple that are backed by science. 1. Boost immunity and reduce the risk of viral and bacterial infections. 2. Facilitates digestion and improves digestive health. 3. Reduces inflammation. 4. Provides pain relief against arthritis. 5. Improves heart health. 6. Speeds up recovery after surgery or strenuous exercise. 7. May reduce the risk of cancer. 8. Improves respiratory health. 9. Improves memory. 10. Promotes healthy bones. Now, let's briefly explain how pineapple performs these wonderful functions in the body. Pineapple contains a digestive enzyme called bromelain, which can assist in protein breakdown and digestion in the gut. In fact, pineapple is the only fruit currently known to contain bromelain, and that's why some use it as a meat tenderizer to help break down the protein and soften the meat. Once this enzyme gets into your body, it makes it easier for foods to get digested, thereby facilitating absorption of nutrients. Bromelain also has anti-inflammatory properties, which can help reduce inflammation in the body and relieve pain in conditions such as arthritis and gut problems. And together with a high vitamin C content, bromelain can also help boost the immune system, reduce the risk of infections, and speed up tissue repair, thereby speeding up recovery after injury and surgery. The high content of fiber, vitamins, and minerals in pineapples can also help improve heart health and reduce the risk of heart diseases. And because pineapple is also an excellent cerebral toner, it combats loss of memory and improves the mood. Now, as for cancer, since the uncontrolled cell growth in cancer is linked to oxidative stress and chronic inflammation, the anti-inflammatory property of bromelain in pineapple may help reduce the risk of certain types of cancer, such as breast and colon cancer. Although some studies have shown that bromelain may treat cancer that has already developed to a level, it's not yet proven that the level of bromelain in pineapple will be enough to support that function. So there's need for more studies involving humans. Pineapple is also able to help keep the bones healthy because of its high content of manganese. Just one cup of pineapple provides about 73% of the daily recommended amount of manganese. So, eating this fruit together with other nutrient-rich foods like whole grains could provide you with a more complete nutrient package and improve your overall health. But despite all these health benefits of pineapple, you should be careful of eating too much of it in one sitting, and there are several reasons for that. For one, because of its sweet nature, people with diabetes should not eat too much of it so as to keep their blood sugar stable and prevent blood sugar spike. Also, because bromelain may affect blood clotting, eating too much may have unintended side effects in people who take blood thinners. It's also been reported that some people who eat a lot of unripe pineapple tend to experience stomach upset, nausea, and diarrhea. So, it's best to stick to ripe pineapples whose flesh is light to medium yellow and eat it in moderation. And lastly, because the bromelain in pineapple digests protein, it equally breaks down the proteins of the mucous lining and surface tissue of your mouth and tongue. And that's why when you eat it in excess, it can cause irritation in your mouth and you get a burning and itching sensation which may last for a while. So it's best to eat pineapple in moderation, or better still, eat it together with a high protein food like yogurt and ice cream. That way, you're already giving the enzyme another protein to digest instead of the ones in your tongue, and that will prevent the irritation. Overall, pineapples are delicious, versatile, and loaded with nutrients and antioxidants, which have been linked to impressive health benefits. Adding pineapple to your diet is easy, as you can eat it blended, roasted, salted, or even fresh. But remember that the best way to eat fruit for good health is to eat it mostly in the fresh state. So, eat your pineapples more as a fresh fruit than in any other form. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If yes, then give this video a like and share with others so they will enjoy it too. And be sure to watch other videos on our channel to learn more about how your foods can help you get healthier.